I put all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We are happy to meet one another and be in the presence of the Lord this morning. And we thank God for the couples meeting that was there yesterday. And we are having a youth meeting after this service at Queen's Park Tepaleku. So all the youths are invited to go there. So let's go there in numbers. The program there will help you a lot as the youth. We don't waste much of your time. We open our Bibles to Zephaniah. It's in the Old Testament.
It's
in the
Old Testament.
1:12. Says it shall come to pass at that time that I will set Jerusalem with candles and punish the men that are set on their knees, that say in their heart, the Lord will not do good, neither will he do evil. Let us pray. Oh Heavenly Father, we approach your throne, Father, reverently, Father, knowing that this is the greatest privilege that we can ever have this side of eternity, to have fellowship and with you, Lord Father, approaching your throne, Lord Father, through the blood, the shed blood of the Lamb. Wherein, Father, we have no more condemnation, but we have access even to the hidden manna of the day. May you break the word of life, Lord Father, the bread of life to every hungry soul, that, Father, we will go here, Lord, satisfied, having power to overcome, having power to meet the challenge of the hour. As the word is being preached, may the attributes of the word be manifested, as we shall deliver the captives and heal the sick. Heal those that are lost, cleanse them by your blood, and fill them by your spirit, Lord Father. Like with those things into your hands, may your preeminence and crush them because of evil and feet in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated.
I shall pass.
It's a prophetic book there. It's a man. He says, they will set Jerusalem with candles.
And they
punish the men that are seated. And they are saying, the Lord will do not
disobey.
The great day of the Lord is near. It is near and distant greatly. Even the voice of the day of the Lord, mighty men shall cry therein bitterly. Even those who are great Christians,
there
will be disappointment to those who are not born again. They shall cast their silver in the streets, and their gold shall be moved, and their silver and gold shall not be able to deliver them. So, your finances, you cannot bribe that day. I'm preaching to you about the update on prophets. The message is a message of prophets. Though it has many nice things of healings and deliverances that
The
central thing is you better, but it is a message of prophets. We want just bump into the future without being warned of God. The Lord does nothing before he reveals to you seven prophets. We have a prophetic ministry that opens our eyes and anoints them with eyes of to see the mysteries of our time. Jesus tells the disciples that blessed are your eyes because they see these things. Because many holy men of God desire to see these things, but they do not see them. So he says to Abraham, shall I hide from Abraham what I'm about to do? The future is already written. The evil eyes of prophecy have seen the unfolding of events. In all spheres of life, political, religion, church, religion,
everything
is recorded in the word
prophetically.
That's why you must keep the book to be oriented. Align with the spiritual event of your time. Modern events made clear by prophecy.
Daniel
was not a lazy Christian, was reading the books of Jeremiah and the prophets. He knew that it's going to unfold. So there are books that you should read, the spoken books, the Bible, to make you understand. When you see the modern events, you must see beyond the humanistic realm what is happening spiritually and what time it is. Even the doomsday clock was saying it's now 2 minutes before midnight. And it's even moving to maybe 1 minute because of the Venezuela things that are happening there. There's a nuclear threat that is threatening this world. Because the Malachi verse is a day that shall balance and open. But the righteous is safe on himself. Because the righteous shall walk on the ashes of the wicked. He says, if you want to see what time or end is, as it is, look at Israel. When you see the fig tree putting forth these buds, you know that summer is nigh.
Come on, time is here.
Israel is that fig tree, they are blooming, they are about to build their temple. And when they finish their temple, they won't finish their temple, building can finish when we are here on earth. The church must be taken in the rapture. And before the Israel days resume in this mysterious seventh week of Daniel. If you don't know what time it is, you may dress the wrong way for that time. You may come out in pyjamas when it's during the day. You may act the wrong way and which is not for this time. This is not time to play church. It's the slam tuning time. When you see the signs in heaven above and earth below. The moon represents the church. Bring light on it when the sun is out. The sun is Christ. When he went away, the church is to bring the light on the earth.
Christ, we are like that
point that we are being
here.
But now when the moon, the church moon was in the people, they should be the light of the world. But when
you
see an eclipse where the earth is actually. The moon is now dark. The church is eclipsing. Even when the church
is
preached, sign of the time. When the rest of the world is just viewing me, what is happening this Sunday, you must see through the spiritual eye. The world is experiencing back pains. They get stronger and stronger towards the back. In 16 April 2016, 38 volcanoes were erupting at the same time.
16 April 2016, Baba Lama Volcano 38 Avapona is
16 December 2007, there was a mudslide that destroyed every village in Chile and China.
Christ in the years of his prophets,
To judge the whole world.
And
he John is told, blessed is he that repents. And they that hear the words of this prophet. In case you did not read, you are still blessed to hear what we are saying now.
But
in
2
Peter it says, chapter
1, verse 21.
The prophets did not come on all by the will of men.
But as prophets, that is aware of the
holy men of God spake as they were moved of Holy Spirit.
Then he
was saying,
then
he just
says,
My father, why is thou forsaking me? Until the day dawns and the day star shines in your heart. But no prophecy of scripture is of private interpretation. God is his own interpreter. We must be inspired by
prophets.
We must be empowered by prophets. And the wind took them away.
And
there was no place for that image anymore. But the stone that is Jesus Christ
grew
and covered the
whole.
That is what happens also to salvation.
So
the image of him, the ancient, is crushed by the stone of the
world.
That same hour the hands came forth and brought in a plaster above the candlestick. Thou art weighed in balances.
And
you are found wanting. Your days are numbered. Your kingdom is divided. Even Christians are weighed in balances of the word of God. The handwriting was upon over the candlestick. So the candlestick of that dossier is written the same. All these wars, rumors of wars, and
the
handwriting on the wall.
Daniel
started dreaming. Before beasts that came, the lion was the first. Representing the head of that image, which is Babylon.
Babylon.
The next beast that came was a bear. Which was
Medo-Persian
leper. The next beast was a leopard. Which was the Grecian Empire. The other one could not describe it fully.
Daniel chapter 7
answers Daniel chapter 2.
Pedula Daniel chapter 2.
Scripture answers Scripture.
Balu Pedula Balu.
Spoken word clarifies another spoken word.
Vela ukanya eleni.
Inspiration interprises another inspiration.
Sermon clarifies
another sermon. So the head of gold was the same as the lion, Babylonian Empire. In the
Babylon Empire.
The silver. Was on the chest. That's why the rebellious reeds.
It's carrying three ribs
on its mouth there. Because that's the chest area anyway. I'm going to explain what those three ribs are. Then the Greek Empire came over and took over under Alexander the Great. Then came the Roman Empire. This Babylonian kingdom lost its speed in the days of Belgium. Shaza. That's why the Bible says the land was given a man's heart. He started moving at the speed of a man. He lost the speed that it had when it was conquering every place. Then after the Persian Empire, after Babylonian Empire, after the then came the bear with many reeds in his mouth. Which are the three provinces of Persia that were conquered by the bear. But the bear was lifted one side. There was a time when the meat were more stronger than the
patience.
There was a time when the patience was stronger than the meat. Then after that came another beast, which was a leopard. The four generals of Alexander were the heads. Not seven heads, because headship is one, not head is one. Now Daniel explains it in chapter
8.
You must not miss service. Because the next service, they answer what you don't understand in the other service. What you don't understand in chapter 7 is answered in chapter 8.
Somewhere
for this little horn. Then when he came next service in chapter 8, he starts a different subject. Then in that subject he clarifies the little horn. He looks at the coming of the Greek Empire. Taking over from the realm. Which is the Medo-Persian Empire. Then the God came with fury and crushed the realm. It came in such a way that it did not touch the ground. You understand that the leopard had wings, it did not touch the ground. That leopard is now what we call the goat here. And that bear is now what we call the ram. The picture is changing. But now, among the four generals of the leopard, four heads of the leopard, which are now horns. One of the horns draws a little horn there. And it goes conquering the whole world and it grows to be of power. A king understanding dark speeches.
Who says
from 2,300 years? coming of Christ may be in the tribulation time. From those days till they reach 2025.
You
can't calculate accurately because of the Julian calendar and astrology calendar and the change of calendar, Jewish
calendar.
Unless those days are shortened, no flesh can be saved.
Just makes
you a hint of the timeline. So Daniel, he did not want to end the dream as if it's a nightmare. Like a lion. What does it mean? that it has a mouth like a lion, it will speak like the Babylonian Empire. But let us make an image. But he that does not bow to this image shall be killed. That is the mark of the beast. Like the beast of the Roman ones. So that beast, it was defeated at a deadly wound when Pacandrome was demolished. Then it comes now as the mist.
Babylon.
Is now something religious about it. It's now the papal Rome.
So we papal Rome that
there are some things that will rebuild the go out of the church.
They
come
in and
steal that form. When we rebuke ministers, people will come with long dresses that are
made.
That's the same thing now in a mysterious form. So he had missed the Babylon. That
tactic
of the devil became mysterious. It had been the prophet to unveil that. Because even John wondered with great admiration. And the angel says, why did you wonder? He says, I'll show you the mystery. Then John says, no wonder why. I was against all organized religion. It was the ecumenical move. Every move that is not led by the word of God is part of that beast system. It's part of the mark of the beast. Vicarious spirit day instead of the Son of God. And blasphemous
names.
So that little one is the Antichrist spirit in the last days. When the devil shall be incarnate in the man. And that he shall set forth a new world order. Now, when we see it in the beast of Daniel, we must also see it in the headlines of the newspaper. We must also see it in CNN. That's what happened on the 5th of February.
February.
When the Pope made the historic visit to Arab Emirates, being the first Pope to visit the Arab Emirates, there was such an expensive display of beauty and the kingdoms that were joining together. Because all religions must join under one force to persecute those who don't bow to them. Muslims, false Christians, and Hinduism must join. So those who are not under that beast cannot buy or sell without the mark of the beast. It was the first Pope to talk about the mass in the territory of the Arabs. It shows that time is at hand. When we see these things, look up, your redemption is
done.
These modern events are made clear by prophecy. When this is happening, you should watch Jerusalem and see what is happening there. When
we
hear Trump sounding his trumpet saying, Jerusalem belongs to the Jews. Because America must make a covenant with the Jews. They must be friendly with the Jews. Because America is another part of the beast. We should give power to the first beast. So they moved their embassy to Jerusalem. And there is a protest that they didn't care about the protest. We should learn from that. When you are determined to do something, you know it's like when the devil protests, don't care. This world, the open up is free up. Armageddon is free up. Because the Bible says in Revelation chapter 11, verse 18 there, the nations were angry. There are three angry things in Revelation. You read the anger of a nation that leads to World War III. In Revelation chapter 11. Then in chapter
12,
you will read about the anger of the dragon. The devil himself, because all these wealthy kingdoms and presidents, many of them are in the secret societies. In the conspiracy of kingdoms, the devil rules all kingdoms. In the inner circles that we don't know about. In the circles of the Satanism inside the
kingdom.
Now, then there's the word of the Lamb. In Revelation chapter 6. When men shall run to the rocks and mountains to hide. Now, these sophisticated weapons of warfare. There's never been a time in history when men has enough weaponry to destroy the whole world in seconds. America dropping the mother of all bombs. In Afghanistan there.
When
there's such a show of power and competition of who has power. In the spiritual, they'll be shut down soon. Also, this military shutdown is just rehearsing the spiritual shutdown on Mount Zion. We see the Russian president warning about World War III. The Russian president is saying, World War III, we are preparing now. Now he claims to have a weapon that cannot be detected by the anti-nuclear systems of the United States. It
moves
faster than it can be detected. It cannot be detected by the devil when it's coming to attack
you.
You know, in this modern technology, they want to make a weapon that cannot be detected when it's
going.
And the devil is also bringing many things in the church that cannot be detected by blind ministries. The unrest that is happening in Venezuela there is a potential threat for the world war. Because the third world war is just looking for a center to start in. And now the timbers are high, superpowers are about to clash over that today. But we saw in every year getting so close. Why is the world war not happening as expected? It's because of Revelation chapter 7, verse 1. There are four angels holding the four winds of the earth. The winds in the Bible represent wars. Now when four winds blow together, there is a whirlwind. which is a world war.
So
he says, we should not know until we see the servants of God.
He's
stopping the wars, giving you enough time to prepare for
God. Then
Jeremiah says in chapter 25, verse 32, thus said the Lord of hosts, evil shall go from nation to nation,
and a
great whirlwind shall rise from the course of the earth. The slain of the Lord shall in that day be from one end of the earth to the other. They shall not be lamented or buried, they shall be stamped upon the earth. We are all in bed pains. All nature is groaning, waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. When this uprising started, people from nation to nation, it started in Libya. When the camera didn't just do it, the normal video filming. So this angel says, have not the air or the sea until
you have
sealed the servants of God in their foreheads.
12,000
of Reuben, 12,000 of this,
12,000.
And those were the Jews.
No, not you.
But after that, there's a crowd that woman put number that are the Gentiles of all nations and tongues. So the 144,000 are the Jews, they are not the Gentiles.
144,000 are
so they are brought back to their tribal order by the ministry of Moses, Elijah, in Revelation 11. But at that time there will be tribulation to the Gentiles. A time of trouble such as has never been.
And
the Jews will build their temple there. When I went to America, I stood at a place that was very interesting. This place was the old Masonic temple. The prophet was standing somewhere in these steps there. The prophet was standing somewhere in those steps when he saw the seven major visions that will happen before the rapture. The first one was the rising of Mussolini and his mysterious end. And then the next one was the America, was the rising of Hitler and his mysterious end also. The next one was the Trinism, Nazism, Fascism, and Communism. They were somewhat in communism. We don't expect isms here, chaos in the church, and I can swallow it, otherwise, think of the poor, think of the generous, the shoners, the smart, the watch. There are no isms here. There is Christianity only. There is no church politics. Then the fourth one was an advance in science and technology. Until they were now egg-shaped cars. Controlled the roads. Vehicles in remote control. A perfect car that cannot have accidents because of the control there. That was the advanced technology.
But
the fourth dimensional slender and beauty invention. Then the fifth one must not involve our sisters in. It was a moral decay. When people threw away modesty and went back to meet means again. And it is empowered. It is truly very
different.
Then the sixth one was a beautiful but cruel woman in America. But he mentioned that he made a president in America. He made the rise of Catholicism because a woman in the Bible represents a church. We don't know if it's happening now in this time when there's a threat of nuclear weapon. It was the total cataclysm and destruction of the land of America to debris a nuclear hole. Maybe people who don't understand what a nuclear bomb is, they don't understand why people line up now and say lie.
Because
when that war starts, there will be no nation spared, exactly. And one day people shall remain, but the radiation will be too much for this world.
Even Africa
is not taking care of power, some strange missiles will hit Africa.
Africa
is sending to Russia, some will fall in Africa. This is so terrible. When they drop a few of them, they can destroy the whole of America. No one is a good winner in such a war because the rent is covered by one weapon, but that can destroy the whole of this Zimbabwe, and the rent can destroy human beings away from the site.
When
you are going around normal business and these things starts, the day that shall burn as an oven. And the Bible says things are going to get worse and worse. There will be no national repentance. The nation is born, it's just you individuals that are
repenting.
But soon that will be over when you are preaching to souls in prison. Now, you just mark that down, you young children. See how far see you get worse and worse until these guys catch fire. She will fall to the end and head will bear a feather him. That's why the paper says. All elements shall bear with fervent heat. He says, seeing that all these things shall be destroyed. What manner of persons ought you need to be in
holy communication?
Brother, it's going to be bad in that day.
Oh,
my loving brother, when the world's on fire. Won't you like God's cause to be your
people?
It won't be time to look for God then. When your salvation fear and tremble now. When they are looking for nuclear shelters, there is a shelter from all sin. There is a precious hiding place in Jesus Christ. And the prophet prophesied about Los Angeles. That field that is spread from there to the whole world. The earthquake that shall shake in San Andreas fall there. It shall sink in the sea. So the days of America are numbered. The days of superpowers are numbered. Even the days of Russia are numbered. Because America shall be destroyed by Russia. But when Russia is boasting of that victory, Ezekiel chapter 38. Attack the Israeli people, go game and go. And all those invading armies shall be destroyed. Because Michael shall stand for his people. Though there shall be a time of trouble such as has never been. There is someone who specializes in standing in such times. When there is a crisis of your life, that's when Michael stands. That is Jesus. He shall deliver everyone whose name is written in the book of life. The nuclear explosion will clear everything. And we shall be debris. It shall burn as an oven. It takes just one drunk man who knows the cause to just switch them on. The candle, all the children, everything that is will be in danger from that nuclear explosion. But in that world, because we are saved, that time will have gone. But those who shall remain, please, when we come, explain how it will have happened. UK in
30 seconds.
Then we have the way that can destroy them within 1 second. Russia was testing its Saturn 2.
Russia tested the bomb of Saturn 2 missile.
They say it is unstoppable. They say American defense mechanisms cannot stop it. The one bomb is bigger than it is very big, but they are going to launch it. Before they make these weapons, they start the defense mechanism of their enemy. The devil starts with your defense before he attacks you. But the
devil
will defeat him anytime, any place, under any
circumstance.
Now, when they are testing these nuclear weapons, it fulfills the second trumpet, where he saw a great mountain of burning fire cast into the sea, and the fish of the sea died. That's why we see these millions and billions of fish there. It is a fallacy that I will sweep away the birds of the air and the fish of the sea. Right now, there is a war threat of nuclear war threat between America and China. These are the U.S. navies in the South China Sea. That's what is threatening war. The ship warships of the US are in the South China Sea. Preparing for the war there.
My
take comfort in this statement of the prophet. Before one drop of water fell in Noah's ark, they were saved in the ark. Before there was fire struck Sodom, Lot was gone. Before the atomic power blow this earth into pieces, the church should be gone. This old world can never hold. If you have kept this word, the Bible says, because you have kept the word of my patience, I will keep you from the hour of trial, the hour of temptation that shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell in the earth. This is a shaking time. Is it falling away? But we have not received the kingdom that cannot be shaken. He that endured to the end shall be saved. If you hold fast to this message to the end,
Microseconds.
These things are speaking that time is at hand. We must prepare and be ready. When there is an earthquake, you don't know what to hold to because everything is shaking. Politics is shaking. Churches are shaking. Family life is shaking. Technology is shaking. Nuclear powers are shaking. But we have received the kingdom that cannot be shaken. On Christ, the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. You cannot be shaken when you are in Christ. I am under the rock that is higher than I. At the time of the sixth seal, because when the sixth seal was opened, the star became as black as sackcloth. The stars of heaven fell down. Heaven departed as a scroll. And the kings of the earth and rich men and captains, they went to the dens and the rocks to say hide. Everyone will look for a rock to hide. But I found the rock that is Jesus. So if you don't cry to the rock Christ now, you will cry to the rocks then. Now every mountain and island shall be removed. The heaven shall depart as a straw. It shall be hailstones that shall rain on the earth. Who brings this seal is the Moses and Elijah ministry. They still plant on this earth. And the angel shall try to let the fire proceed from their mouth. It means to be plants coming on the earth as in the first Exodus. So shall it be in the last Exodus. When they finish their test on the beast that arises from the bottomless pit shall overcome them, and their bodies shall lay in the streets called Sodom and Egypt spiritually for 3.5 days. What people are raised and giving gifts for another, don't miss a prophecy there. The Bible says, all the people of the world shall watch this prophecy.
umhlaba uzawubukela le mzimba yabantu.
What prophecy is that?
Prophecy esinjani?
Technology and live streaming.
Itechnology nokubona.
Those in Zimbabwe will be watching those bodies.
Wonke umuntu uzabe bukele le mzimba.
That is live streaming and television.
Live streaming and
TV. But why they were watching and rejoicing?
Kodwa besathokoza bebukele.
The spirit of life comes into the prophecy and they rise.
Impilo wangena kibo baphakama.
You must not rejoice when you are down because you shall rise.
Thokoze ngaphansi ngoba uzaphakama.
Those who are listening and watching the news.
Nabade belalele bebukele news.
I'm not talking about watching dishes and television. Watch and pray. Then Iran leader was saying we need 3 days to destroy
Israel.
But Israel is joined with the big brother. That is America.
Okay, America.
They won't be able to deal with Israel without fighting America. That's what
Zechariah
saw. When he says, in that day I'll make Jerusalem a bed and some store.
What he can
and those that betted themselves against Israel shall be cut to pieces. He says, I will make Jerusalem a cup of trembling. Many nations are trying to fight Israel.
Israel
shall be cut to pieces. And Zechariah describes the damage that shall happen in the bodies of those who fight Israel. This plague shall happen to those that come against your son. Their flesh shall consume while they stand on their feet. Their eyes shall consume away in their walls and their tongue shall consume them. Scientifically is the defect of nukes. The nuclear radiation causes exactly that. You'll be standing like this and your eyes disappear, your skeleton remains standing there. So Isaiah was seeing a nuclear warfare coming. So now this joining of America and Israel is a milestone in prophecy. Because the people of Jerusalem begins. And he that keepeth
Israel
shall not sleep for slumber. It's about to cross. What they to gather Israel from all the nations. The same way he gathered us from denominations.
All
nations that called Israel are now in ruins and debris. Their nations are damaged.
Look
at Iraq, look at Libya, look at Syria there. It means to us no weapon formed against you can prosper. We are inching closer to Gog and Magog. And now Daniel prophesied again, saying, many shall run to and fro in Daniel chapter
12.
And technology, knowledge shall be increased. Many of you are carrying something that Daniel saw as technology.
Cell
phones and gadgets. We can be using for preaching. Technology has advanced until the nations like Dubai. They are now going to be in Wi-Fi where the internet will be given by night. LEDs are any internet. Technology is advanced. I think they have robots. That can wait in place of your wife and me, like doing all the kids
and everything.
And we help me to you.
You
can send it to the shops, you can send it anywhere. If it falls, it rises. So a Christian must be better than that. Now we get into levels where even the cooking can be done by robots. We are also like robots because we don't live our own lives. We are pressed by the world to do what it's not us who do our things. advanced until in this world of natural reality, they may experience something that is far apart. These bears are far from the people, but need to be like you are seeing them right there. So when we see the promise of God afar off, we embrace them and we confess that we are pilgrims and strangers. But in all this technology, professing to be wise, they became fools. When people are saying they are wise, they are not fools, they distract God in their lives. They have no time for God anymore. They have no time to pray anymore. They are now lovers of pleasure more than of the word of God. Capacious, boasters, blasphemers, and holy without natural affection, truth breakers. These are the perilous times for the
saints.
They don't know they are so good for what are conditions. Yet his heart also failing for fear. 200 million devils released in the end times. All hell breaks loose. The gate of hell is open. And the gate of hell is also open.
Makrekongi Satan.
Iniquity shall abound.
Usolosizawanda.
And people shall depart from the truth.
Abantu besuke eqinisweni.
Nobody worship money.
Babekhonza imali.
And then all hell breaks loose. There will be all sorts of famines and things and that. And
mark of
the
beast
comes. I think I'll pick it for another time. Teaching is not easy. We'll see how we, when we are in prophecy. Because of my college, started opening his seals there. He says, take heed that no man deceive you. You shall hear rumors of war. When he says, no man deceive you, that is the white horse rider.
Deception.
You shall hear rumors of wars. That is the red horse rider. Matador. Nation shall rise against nation. And people against kingdoms. And there shall be famines. Famines is also the black horse rider. It says there shall be pestilences. And earthquakes in diverse places. So the fourth horse rider, that is the pale horse rider, destroys the pestilences.
These things
are the beginning of sorrows. They shall deliver you to be afflicted. That is the fifth seal. Jewish Holocaust. When the Jews were
martyred.
Then he says there shall be great tribulation. Such as has never been since the world began. That is the tribulation time is sixth seal tribulation. Let no one remain in that time. He says the sun shall be darkened, the moon shall. Then we shall see the Son of Man coming from heaven. When he comes to gather his jewels, that says, he says, two will be the field, one will be taken, one will be left, and two will be riding together. One will be taken, one will be left. Let there be no one who will remain at that time. You must never miss the rapture. You must never miss it, so you must prepare. Nothing short of perfect love shall make it. Nothing short of perfect faith shall make it. Nothing short of being born again shall make it. So we must all then in the way of our salvation be in trembling. Clean up and prepare for that day that is coming. I will ask the soul leader to be ready when they give us the judgment day is coming. What an awful day to be. For my loving brother, when the world's on fire. So that we all go and think about our eternal destiny. If there is anything in your life that can block you from going, you go and repent and make it right. The signs of that time are everywhere. They are just sounding the trumpet, warning the people. Does everyone run to the precious hiding place and be ready for the time that is coming? Because one day we'll preach the last sermon. One day we'll sing the last song. One day we'll call the sinner for the last time. Then the great book is open right there. So we'll all sing that song and we'll all get to a time of prayer.
Ahora leo, no lo tuvo sin que descanses un culero.